In this video, I'm going to show you how to take your local website and post it on a live server. For example, this is our local website that I've created for this demonstration. Beautiful looking website. And if you go to the back end, you'll see everything has been designed perfectly. It has a theme, multiple plugins, everything is set up perfectly. And this is how a website would look like. And if you go to a live server right now, this is how the website looks like. It's not technically a website, it's just a default blank WordPress install. And if you go to the backend, you'll see nothing is here. There's no plugin installed. It's a complete blank WordPress install. And we'll be taking this website right here, which is this one, and just migrating the entirety of this website on this new server or a blank website setup. Now, a couple of things to keep in mind before you begin and follow along this tutorial. The things that you'll need to have is you need to have WordPress set up on your live server. So whatever hosting you're using, Bluehost, SiteGround, any other hosting, make sure WordPress is installed. And if you haven't started your website yet, there'll be a link down in the description to sign up with our partner, Bluehost, and you'll be able to set up your WordPress website in just maybe 2 minutes of time. And the second thing to keep in mind is that whatever domain name you want to have for your live website, this domain name is already here. This is also very important. Most hosting providers, including Bluehost, will assign you a temporary domain name before you actually select a live domain name. If you have that, do not perform the migration first. First, connect your actual domain name with the website and only then perform the migration, because a lot of the settings that will be changing or will be changed automatically will depend on the domain name. So make sure everything is set up correctly. So once you have this, once you have a blank WordPress installed and you have connected with the right domain name, you can follow along this process. So let me explain how the process actually works. Thinking about this, how does one migrate a website? A WordPress website is just a collection of files, folders, themes, and a few settings, right? So if you take all those files, the database files, the images, everything, and just migrate it to another server, change some settings, technically everything should work on the new website as well. Now, it's easier said than done because it's technically challenging to do all of this manually. And of course, WordPress has a lot of solutions where you can use plugins to do this. And exactly this is what we'll be doing as well. We'll be using plugins to perform this task and make it easier on us. Now, I'm going to be discussing two different ways or two different, I say, plugins. And you'll understand why I have our different plugins, or I'll be talking about two different plugins. The first plugin that you can use absolutely for free is called All-in-One WP Migration. And I'm not going to specifically talk about this plugin, but I say every single free plugin that I've used, you have a similar workflow that allows you to create one package file, migrate it to a site, and I'm going to demonstrate this in a moment, and then migrate your site over to a live website. Now, the only limitation I ran into, not with this plugin, but almost every single plugin, that they have certain limits that you have to adhere to. And these plugin limits are mostly related to what size your database can be, what is the number of plugins you can have, and overall, what is the amount of, like, say, what's the overall size of your package that you're trying to migrate. And anything above 100 or 150 megabytes usually are not allowed in the free version of most of these plugins. And that's where the problem happens, is if you have a very tiny website, then it's okay. If you just have a couple of plugins, then it's workable. But if you're designing your entire website like this, which is complete, like ready to go live, then you will run into these limitations as well, where you won't be able to migrate your entire website using free plugins. Now, I'll give you another solution, and this is the solution we'll be using in this video. And the solution I'm recommending is that you use a plugin called Duplicator Pro. This is the solution I'm going to recommend. Now, just to clarify, Duplicator, you don't have to purchase the premium version. You can actually migrate your entire website, regardless of the site as is, with just the free version as well. But it's a little more technical, so I won't advise it to everyone. But if you are a little technical oriented, and if you don't mind getting your hands dirty with code and setting up databases, there'll be a written guide linked down in the description, which you can go to. You can just use the free version, follow along the guide, and you'll be able to migrate your entire website without having to pay a penny. But if you're like me, you're not technically oriented, and you want to just migrate your website easily, in the easiest way possible, I would recommend Duplicator Pro. Now, another few benefits, or I say few more benefits of Duplicator Pro, even they have to pay a little bit of money, is not only do you get the migration wizard, which we'll be using, you also get the website cloning wizard. So let's say in the future you're looking to migrate your website from one hosting provider to another hosting provider, it can be done instantly without having to purchase another plugin. You also have cloud backups. That means you can backup your site and then upload the backup to Google Drive, Amazon S3, and other cloud hosting providers. You can also have secure backups. That means you can back up your site. You'll also have backups scheduled. That means you can schedule backups to be done every day, every second day, every third day, every week, and they'll be automatically done. You also have a feature which is not listed here, which is called restore points, which is this one-click restore. And what this feature is that anytime you're making a website, you can make a restore point. And anything goes wrong, let's say you install a malicious plugin, your website gets hacked, whatever happens, you can just one-click and that restore point will be instantly triggered and your website will roll back to that instant version. This is a very, very, I'd say, awesome feature inside a WP or inside Duplicator, which will help you be very secure and be very confident about if anything goes wrong, you already have a restore point. You can restore instantly without having to actually go to a backup. So all these features inside WP or all these features inside Duplicator Pro make it a really great choice to not only use for migration, but for backups as well. So you're paying just a single amount or paying once but getting all these features, and that's why my recommendation goes to Duplicate Pro. And again, as I said, you can use the free version as well. That's completely up to you. I'm going to use the premium version. I'm going to demonstrate how you can migrate your entire website with Duplicator Pro. Now, of course, you'll have to make a purchase. I already have made a purchase. I already have an account. I also have the Duplicator plugin file downloaded. I'll show you how you should do this. First, you'll have to make a purchase. You'll have to create an account, which will run in a minute. So then you can log into your account by clicking the My Account button. And once you click inside your account or you reach inside your account, you'll see something like this. Then you'll need to go into Downloads here. And inside Downloads, you'll be able to download the Duplicator plugin. This will come as a zip file because it's not available in the repository. You will have to click this and a zip file will be downloaded onto your computer. You should also click and copy this license key on your clipboard or just save it on your computer so that you can actually authorize and activate the pro copy of Duplicator. Once you have the zip file and you have the license key copy, let's go back to our website here. This is the demo website, or this is the live website. We'll start with the demo website because that's where we are going to first make a copy of the entire website. So I'll go here, and this is the website. I'm going to install Duplicator Pro on this website. I'm going to go into plugins. I'm going to go into add new. I'm going to close this. And since I'm uploading a zip file, not using the search function, not using the WP repository, I'm going to click upload plugin. I'm going to drag the zip file from my computer here. And I'll let go and I'll click install. This is how Duplicator Pro will be installed on your website, and you have to follow the same process. So the plugin is now installed. Let's also activate the plugin. So Duplicator Pro is now installed. We'll also need to enter a license key to activate the plugin. And you can just click this link here, or you can go here and you can activate your license since you already have made a purchase. Let's click here. And this will take us inside Duplicator settings. This is where we'll paste the license key. And we'll say activate. And now the license key has been activated. And just for simplicity, I'm going to make this to info only so that I don't have to hide the license key anymore. I just click this and close this. Now Duplicator Pro has been installed on our site. It also has been activated. And now we'll start the process of creating a package, which means having all your database, all your plugins, everything that's on your site into a single zip file, which we can then import onto a live website. For that, we'll go into Duplicator settings here. We'll go to packages. And inside the packages menu, as I've just installed the plugin, there are no packages. And you can think of packages as backups. So anytime you make a package, consider that as an entire backup of your website. And you can use the backup to restore your site or also migrate your site. Let's start by creating a first package inside by clicking create new. This will start the process of creating a package. And this is the package creation menu. Don't worry, you don't have to worry about all these settings, storage, archive, installer. You just have to remember this name. You can also customize this. However, I won't recommend it because it already has the current date entered with your site name, which is very easy for you to remember and also will help you understand when a particular backup was made. Since I'm recording this video right now, it's 22nd of June, 2023. So I already see this date here. So if I have multiple packages, I can instantly remember or instantly see which package was made on what date, and you can have notes associated with them as well. Once you're ready, once you've made the changes, once you've added a name, you have the template, you don't need to worry about none of the settings you need to worry about. Just click the next button to get started or move to the next step, which is scanning. So when the scanning happens, what Duplicator is doing is identifying everything on your website that everything is in order before a package is made. And it might take some time, so let's hang on and wait for this process to finish. Once the scan is complete, you should see something like this. And you'll see most of them are good, good, good. If your website is in good shape, you might see some warnings or notices. And most of the time, that's completely all right. For example, you see there's a size check here. Size check is here because the website is actually 478.67 megabytes. This is the problem which I was mentioning. Once your website goes or even has like 10 plugins, it eventually reaches a point where you can't use free plugins to migrate your website. But this is completely all right because Duplicator can easily handle large databases as well, so you don't need to worry about this. And what you need to do is a notice has been issued. You'll be presented with another warning if there's a notice, but in case of a size check, you can mostly ignore it. There's no need to worry. Just click the yes or check box and just click the build button, which will start the build process. And this is how the build process looks like. Depending on how big your website is, it might take a few minutes, maybe 5 to 10 minutes of your time. So instead of boring you, I'll just cut the video to when the package has been complete. So this took around 5-7 minutes of time, and now you can see the package has been made. You can see the name right here. You can see the size, 235 megabytes or 32 megabytes after compression. And this is why you need a reliable plugin, because a lot of times free plugins will not be able to upload this big of a file and uncompress it on a live server, and you'll run into problems. So having a reliable plugin is very important. Now you'll start by downloading this package to your computer, but if you click the download button, you'll be presented with a couple of options. Let's explore that. Once you click download, you'll see both files, which means both this and this. But what's the installer? Now installer includes the WordPress files as well. So if you just have a basic server setup, nothing set up on that, no WordPress install, you can use the installer. But in this case, we're not going to use that, because you can just download the archive to our computer, and this will be a 250 megabyte file. Just click on that and the download will start. In my case, I'm using Google Chrome, so once that is downloaded, I'll just move it to a safe place on my computer. So the download is now complete. I'll click the downloads button and I'll show you the downloads right here, what the name is like. I'll click this and you can see the recent download here, which is this file, which is downloaded onto my computer. And you see the name right here. This is what you'll also see. Make sure that it's in a location that you remember. Make sure to save your backups into a certain location. And now once this is done, we'll once again go to our live website and repeat the process by installing the plugin first, and we'll install this setup, or I'd say this package that we downloaded onto the site. The first thing we'll do is we'll go here, and this is the live website I already showed you. We'll go back here and we'll install the Duplicator Pro plugin once again. So we'll go to plugins, we'll go to add new, and once again I'll click upload plugin. I'll drag the zip file here. I'll install the plugin here. So the plugin is now installed. Let's also activate the plugin. And now, once the plugin is activated, it will ask for the license key for the complete activation to take place. Once again, I'll click activate your license. And this is where we'll enter the license key. And I'll click activate. And once again, I'll make it info only just to keep it safe. Now, Duplicator Pro has been installed on the live website where we want to migrate our website. Instead of going to packages, we're going to go to import to start importing the package that we just created. I'll click import. And this is where we'll start importing the process. Now, before I start import, I want to highlight a really cool feature inside Duplicator, which is import link. And Duplicator has this cool feature where you can, instead of downloading the archive, you can just migrate your website directly from a cloud service or just a link. I just wanted to highlight that this is a cool feature inside Duplicator as well. What I'll do is here in the drag and drop location, I'll drag that archive file here. Keep one in mind, depending on the size of the website, it might take 5, 10, 15 minutes for the entire process to complete. So once you drag and drop, just sit tight for 10, 15 minutes. You don't have to do anything. And of course, I'll speed up the video or cut that part out. So let me just drag and drop the file here. Now the process will begin. Again, it will take 10, 15 minutes of your time. So have a coffee, have some free time, or just have a drink, and we'll be back once this is done. So this took a good 15-20 minutes to finish, and now you see the file has been imported. It's ready to import. You see all these green ticks here. That means everything has been detected perfectly. What's the size? Everything is good to go. And once you're ready, once you see all these green ticks, no errors, no warnings, then just click the continue button right here. And this will be a warning to you that recovery point is not active. This is not really useful because we are working with a completely blank website. But if you're working with a website that already has some content, maybe you could set up a recovery point. In this case, it's not very important. So what I'll just do is click the launch installer button. and the installer has begun, but we'll see, have some warnings and we'll have to just make sure that everything is in place before we can start the install. You'll see a lot of confirmation dialog boxes here because we are going to overwrite a lot of things on our website. So it's just making sure that everything is in place. So here's the status, what we're trying to do. This will clear all the database. I don't have to remind you that we're going to completely wipe everything that's on the target website, which is the live website. And since it's a blank install in my case, I don't have to worry. But if you have something important there, back it up or just copy it somewhere else, right? You also see the validation, which is the recovery point is not set. That's completely fine. The PHP migration is also different. That's also completely fine. Both PHPs are compatible. I've tested this out multiple times. If you have a different PHP version on your local site versus your live site, in most cases, it's not going to work or it's not going to cause any problems to you. So once you see all of this, all you have to do is go here at the bottom of the page, click I have read all the terms and conditions or accept the terms and conditions and click the next button, which will start the import process. So let's click that. And once final confirmation you'll get is, hey, this is what you're trying to do. This is the install. This is everything else. And just 20 database tables will be written, everything as good to go. Once you've verified everything, which we already did, just click the OK button. And it'll start extracting the archive, and this takes less than 5 minutes because the upload process has already been done. You see it's already 50%. Let's wait for a couple of seconds. So the import process has finished, but we are not done. There are a couple of steps still remaining to finish the import process. The first thing is that you need to look at this, and this might not be appearing in your install. What this is saying is that, hey, you have a plugin installed or you had a plugin installed on the local site which modified some essential WordPress settings. In my case, it was WPS hide login, which is useful for hiding your login URL for security purposes, and this has been disabled just to keep it simple for you. So keep in mind that you just need to enable the plugins to finish the process. And once a more important thing, you need to click this admin login button, log in with your old credentials, because now everything has been replaced. You log in with your old credentials that were on the local site, and that's how you log in. And once you log in with the new credentials or the old credentials, then the setup file that we just imported will be deleted from the server, and that is when the entire setup process will be complete. So I'll click the admin login button, which will open up in a new tab, and now I'll log in with my old username and password for the local website. So I'll type in my username, which was this. I have the password copied, just press Ctrl V. I'll log in. And you can see directly as I've logged in, this looks exactly like the local website. All the plugins have been installed, all the configuration has been done, and you can see this warning, or I say success message. The site has been successfully migrated, and you'll have to enable this plugin, and just I installed it. Otherwise, if you don't have similar plugins, you might not need to worry about this. And if you have connected an external service like Monster Insights or connecting with Stripe to accept payments, you might need to reconnect them because you've changed your domain name as well. Apart from this, everything should be good to go. Let's open the final site in a new tab just to see how it looks. I'm going to show you URL of this website as well. It's startawwebsite.com/live import, which was the live URL, which was the URL of the live site. Let it open up for the first time. And the website has loaded up. We can see it looks exactly like our local site. It has all the plugins installed. You can go to different pages and it'll appear exactly how it was on the local site. And just to give it a comparison, I'll go back here. I'll open the local site. This is how the local site looked like. Go to the about page. Everything is perfect. And if we go back here and we also go to the media library, let's say we go here and we go to the media library, you'll see all the media that we import on the site is also present here. So let that media library open. I'll show you exactly how the website looks. This is exactly how the local website was. And in the media library, you can see all the media is also being imported. So I already showed the plugins. You can also go into the post and check out all the posts that were imported, media imported. That means everything has been set up correctly with such a easy setup process. You don't have to worry about any technical stuff, anything database related. Just make a package, copy it, and just dump it on the live server, and everything will be taken care of by Duplicator. That's the power of Duplicator. And now you can use the other benefits of Duplicator, like live schedules, backups, restore points, and migration services, to even enhance your site and keep it even more secure. And that's my reason for recommending the Duplicator plugin, because it makes everything so easy. Just migrating a site is so easy, backing up your site is easy, scheduling websites and scheduling backups and restore points is also this easy with Duplicator. So definitely check out the website or check out the plugin from duplicator.com. I'll leave a link down in the description of this video. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, the comment box is open. If you like WordPress education, you can subscribe and like this video as well. You're watching Yuvraj from WP Beginner. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.